question number one. Is it good for a couple to have a joint account? Yes or no? Any of you can answer.
For me, okay.
For me, I don't know, but for me, I don't like it.
Please, can you explain it? Why it's not good?
For me, it's not good. It's not a good idea. Because there are a lot of things might be going on in the relationship, in the marriage. In the other way around, it might be good.
Yeah.
But in the other way, it might not be good. But for my own particular, I don't think it's good. Because you might have things in your homes. Maybe before, you guys are trying to do things together. When the thing is not working from the previous side, but I don't think it's going to work when you make joint account together. When there is no agreement initially. You understand?
Yes.
When the thing is not working, it depends on the foundation of the marriage. That is my explanation.
I have a answer here which says it depends on the relationship and love that they have in marriage. When they don't have love in their marriage, I don't think the joint account can stand. I don't think it. God bless you, ma. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Question number two. Is it good for a boyfriend and girlfriend to do blood group test before getting married? Sister Beauty, you can answer the question.
For me, it's not good. Or for me, it's good for one side, but it's not good for the other side.
Please, can you give us your reason?
It's like a boyfriend and girlfriend is going. Maybe they went to the hospital and do blood test. They can't. There will be mistake there. So the other one, will say, I cannot marry you. The other one says, I cannot marry you. So they will separate. But if they do not do the blood test, their marriage will go on.
Okay. Please, can I ask you some question? What about time to come? They now have problem in their marriage. Please, can somebody answer? Please, one second.
Yeah, it's very good for a boyfriend and girlfriend to make a blood test because one might be AS and the other one might be SS. You understand? So, in this area, it's better. To me, I felt like it's better not to have a child than to have a child that will just come to the world and die.
God bless you, sir. Any other person? Mama.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
I think I'm blessed to be on this morning.
But I think one thing that we fail to realize as believers is that you don't marry because you just feel like marrying. That's one thing. And any marriage that is not built on Christ, I'm telling you, there is a tendency that it can crash at any time. When you see somebody that you want to marry with, I think the first thing you need to do, pray. When you pray and you have the conviction that, well, this is the right partner, my brothers and my sister, be it AS or this, whatever, God is going to take control of that marriage. It is the wise people that are brought in that situation and say, do test for AS or whatever. But if you pray, God is going to give you the right gift.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Thank you, ma'am. Praise the Lord. the Lord.
Hallelujah.
I have another question which says, okay, ma. God bless you, ma.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
See, sometimes we are giving God work. God has given us brain to think. It is an error for you to know that this marriage is not, the couple, the people intending to marry, they are both SS. And you now say, let me risk my fate to marry. It's not wise. It's not a wise decision. No matter how Christian you are. Because we find out that people who have SS and AS, when they get married, they suffer a lot.
Of course.
You see women who have four children, they lost all of them. You train them till they are, when you are supposed to, they just die. You get into pain, you suffer tears. You know what it is to be in labor. So, Bible says if you want to build a house, count the cost. If you know you cannot finish it, don't start it. If you know say you know go finish, don't give what God work, pastor work. You start be praying, having SS. You knew it before you enter. Don't enter it. It is not a wise decision. It only happens if it is by mistake you have. That is why we advise. Do the necessary checks before you marry. It is not a wise thing as a Christian that you know that you are SS. You now risk it and say, let me use faith to marry. It is not wisdom. Praise the Lord. So we encourage our children, no matter how you are in love, when you discover that this relationship will lead nowhere because of our blood group is not compatible, don't go ahead with that marriage. God bless you.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
But our brother, we wait to please. There is no time, sir. Okay, we'll give you 1 second, please. No more than 1 second, please.
Praise the Lord.
Outside.
You see, all these tests are not tests. We are the one causing problem for ourselves. Before you go into marriage, when you are in a relationship and you want to marry, you always pray, God, is this the person that you make for me? Whenever God show you that, yes, there's no need of going making tests, because God cannot give you something that will cause you problem tomorrow. God said that the blessings of God make a rich and added no sorrow. So when you are going to test, anything that you see is because of your unbelieving.
Thank you.
So making this test is not good.
Thank you, sir. God bless you, sir. Please, I have another question, which says, is it good for a woman to leave her home, her house, in the morning and come back late in the night? When the man asks her where she went to, she will be insulting the man. Is it good?
No.
It's error. It's not good. Okay. I have another question. This one is for the children. Is it good for a man to beat his or her child? The woman will be angry. That is number one. Number two, is it good to spoil our kids with phone? A child of 1 year, from 1 year to 6 years, we will be buying phones for them. Please, I need answer.
And for me?
Yeah.
The first answer, for a man will be beating his children in front of his wife and the woman will be angry. That is total no. For the second one, I think every mother knows that giving a child, giving a phone to a child in the early stage is error too. It's a total no for that.
God bless you, ma'am.
And also it can affect the eyes of the children.
Yeah.
Amen. Yeah. And we are not giving the children the phone because we love them. Amen. So we have to think of their eyes and their health.
God bless you, ma. Thank you, ma.
Yeah.
The last question is this. This is the last question. And the complication can also answer it. Is it good for a Christian brother or sister to be in Europe and go back, to stay in Europe and go back home to marry?
It's not good.
Who can answer it? Please, we need a... Okay, Dikini, that was okay. Somebody is here, sir.
I will answer this question based on circumstances. Depends.
Okay.
You understand?
Yes, sir.
Because you are in Europe and you have everything you're looking for here. And at the same time, you're having complication of the things that you have here. Mm-hmm. And you said, oh, maybe it doesn't fit and let me go back home. But the thing is, what you have here, sometimes it's difficult to fix and you want to go home to get something that you don't want to expose to the people. You understand? But I also see it on the other hand as a caging, bringing a woman back home and not exposing the woman, and finding a woman here that is already exposed to the world. But most of the people here that are exposed, they take advantage of it. And this is why the men, sometimes they are a little bit scared.
Okay, sir. Thank you, sir. God bless you.
Praise the Lord. Just like as you said from the beginning, it depends. So for instance, you have a fiancé before leaving Nigeria to abroad. It is wise, if you are still able to go back home and marry him or her, is a good decision. But you also need to have a condition by keeping yourself here. You cannot be using people here, and at the end of the day, they are not good for you for marriage. Then you go back home and get that one. So if you know you already have somebody at home in mind, please, as you are here, answer. Fat zip up.
God bless you, sir.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
You know, marriage is a school you can never be finished. People bad will say, whenever you find a wife, that is where you belong. Just like we come to church now, we are calling our papa, our daddy. Before I left Africa, I had pastor. But the pastor in Africa now, is he the one praying for me or the pastor here? Because when we are in Europe, then it's better you marry which you know than you go marry big one. That record, it will demote your blessing to zero. Then you bring her, because many of us don't learn, there are many people who go marry come from Africa now. Now the wife don't leave them. Many of them, they journey there. They spend a lot of that one I married between a boyfriend and girlfriend.
So God bless you, sir.
If you see a wife, yeah, that good, though. No,
praise the Lord.
God
bless you, sir. Time is not on our side, though. Please, we just have just 5 minutes. 2 minutes to round up everything.
Okay, I think the first thing depends on the reason why you are going to marry the woman.
Mm-hmm.
Are you going to marry the woman because you want to honor God's word?
Mm-hmm.
Or you want to go and marry the woman to come and use the woman as a slave?
Mm-hmm.
That you should also think of. Because most of the time, because of those that are here, you cannot use them anyhow. You will choose to go and bring somebody else. Mm-hmm. And you want, when the person comes, you will use that individual as a footstool. And mind you, he's supposed to be what? A helpmate. That we should also consider. And the same thing with the women, like our daddy there was saying. If you know you have somebody down there,
mm-hmm.
when you are here, maintain yourself, both
of
men
course.
And women.
Of course.
But if not, then
otherwise. Are we blessed?
Yes.
Are we blessed? Yes. Me, I'm blessed. Oh.
Amen. Amen. And my answer goes like this. You know, in Europe, let's be realistic to ourselves. In
mm-hmm.
Europe, many women in Europe, they always cause problems.
Yes, sir.
You know, we are not a white, we are African. Many women always talk about white wedding. What is the meaning of white wedding? What we know is that it's traditional marriage, not white wedding. But many women in Europe, they always like to oppress, do what the white people doing. Only to oppress men, which is very bad. That is why sometimes men lose hope from the women in Europe. They decide to go back home and go and start from square one. Bring out the one that brought up well in the father's home. Because the moment they enter Europe, they change their character. That is my question. That is my answer.
Thank you,
God bless you.
Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
I hope you bless you.
Please, I want to answer my brother. They say no woman is perfect. you going to Africa to marry, you are causing a problem to yourself. Because all women are the same. You marry in Europe, you marry in Africa, it's the same. You going to Nigeria tomorrow or any Africa country, you don't know that person. You don't know what that person is doing. They can pretend as a chameleon because they want to go to Europe. So my advice for all the men, anywhere you are married there, good or bad, arrange them. No woman is not good. All women are good. It depends how you handle them, how you talk to them, how you cherish them and love them. So please, my brothers and sisters, show love to your wife.
Praise the Lord. God bless you. Anywhere where you get married. You say Europe, you go marry for Nigeria, na problem. If you come here, come here, na problem. Because you go pretend she need a visa.
Yes,
sir. When you tell where she don't come here, you the one where they talk to her before, she go say yes, sir. Now that time, she go bring her character.
That you should also think. Because most of the time, because of those that are here, you cannot use them anyhow. You choose to go and meet
okay,
them. And the person that you work on, you choose that individual as a to. And mind you,
hallelujah.
He supposed to be what? A healthy
God bless you, our women.
That we should also God bless the same thing with women
and each and every one of you, the name of Jesus.
If you know you have somebody down there,
good time
when
to
you are here, maintain yourself. Both men and women.
Your program.
But if you also the other one.
When it comes to marriage, sometimes we the men, we always put it on the women. Amen. We are good in putting it on the women. Amen.
Amen.
You the man that is saying that you need someone that is not wise and you are wise. Mind you, the person you are going down to go and bring, time will come, should be wiser than you.
God bless you, sir. Amen.
Amen. She will be wiser than you because there's an adage that says, you know, when you tie a goat or a rat or dog, you just lose the dog. You see the way you will run. Amen.
Amen.
Because you just lose the animal. Now, you bring in a woman from Africa, one, she don't know the system in this place. The women that are here, they understand the system. Amen.
Amen.
Then, if it happened that she met the wrong one, they will teach her the wrong way to go. And she's coming against you with us. But the women here, just like many of us here, you go to Africa to go and build a house. Who sees you will be seeing you as a very big person. But not knowing that you are living in one room self-contained here.
Of course.
But the one you marry here will understand that in this place you manage. Mm-hmm. But you go home to go and do whatever you are going there to go and do.
Yes.
So she come here, which she know that you have a duplex. And come here, she found you in one self-contained. My brother, you are gone.
Oh.
Amen.
Amen.
You are totally gone. Glory to God. The fact is that all women are good. All men are good. All men are bad. All women are bad. So you, the man, it depends on you how you coordinate your house.
Thank you, sir. Praise the Lord. God bless you. Righteous women.
It's
time. No time.
Pray, Master Jesus.
Hallelujah.
All is well spoken. Pray, Master Jesus. Everybody just speak well.
Okay.
You know, life depends. Before you live a life, this electricity before you walk is positive and negative.
Yes.
Life is positive and negative. Two positive cannot work, while two negative cannot work. Pray, Master Jesus.
Hallelujah.
He said that the man is hot, the woman is cold. Or the man is hot, the woman is cold. That is how you live life. Pray, Master Jesus. I can count series of my friends who have heart attack, hypertension because of a woman at Nigeria. Pray, Master Jesus. Because your family once does not like a woman. And your family now will be thinking that you are spending all your ends on the woman. So every day, you will be a catering problem upon problem. pray, Master Jesus. If you are a role, but as a Roman. That is where you walk that name of jungle justice. Where you are. That is where you are.
God bless you, sir.